There are a lot of reasons to bemoan the sudden ubiquity of social media in our lives, but it does have its benefits. Interconnectivity allows us to observe broad societal trends and ripple effects playing out in something like real time. Granted, it's mostly trends and ripple effects related to media as consumed by the First World, but since I make a living writing and making videos about media consumed largely by the First World, it's an invaluable tool as far as I'm concerned. Case in point, about a week ago, I was privy to observe an amusing moment in cross-cultural entertainment news reaction. The news? Chaim Saban, the insanely wealthy television producer best known for launching the Power Rangers franchise in the West, has finally partnered with a major studio to pull the trigger on a new big-budget movie reboot of the original series. The reaction to this across my social media and regular media feed was about what you'd expect, with reactions falling neatly on generational lines. Millennials were psyched, Generation Xers rolled their eyes, entertainment journalists and/or movie critics also rolled their eyes, especially if they were also Generation Xers themselves, and that's the part that so amused me. See, a lot, and I mean a lot, of the my-aged, i.e. 30 to 40-year-old movie reporters snarking dismissively about the very idea of a present-day Power Rangers movie were folks I know for a fact are enthusiastic boosters of the current blockbuster landscape so utterly dominated by movies based on comic books and toys and old cartoons. Hell, for many of us, that's the basis of our current employment. Let's not play cute about this. Movie journalism, especially internet movie journalism, is right now overwhelmingly dominated by Generation X film geeks who grew up marinated in D&D, Star Wars, comics, video games, action figures, and the cartoons based on the same, which gives them an edge in reporting on an industry currently fixated on the same stuff. Not just in terms of a knowledge base, but also in terms of an ability to engage with material with whatever modicum of serious consideration it deserves. Any damn fool can spend 10 minutes on Wikipedia and tell you why there's a dinosaur in the Transformers 4 trailer. Hey, how come that movie isn't called Transformers, by the way? But because, say, I have more than a passing familiarity with those characters, and can offer some cursory insight as to who they are, why fans are reacting the way they are, and what interesting things could mean for the film narratively, as opposed to an old guard critic whose reaction is just, "Oh lord, the cars are also dinosaurs now?" Or, "Heavens, save me from these films made from wretched playthings! That's why I get this show, while all they get is... the ever-darkening cloud of obsolescence looming over their heads. So what's the deal with all these guys and gals with the same basic job as me and the same basic background as me doing the rolling eyes and heavy sighs over a Power Rangers movie? Do they not perceive the implicit irony over this? Now, I'm not gonna sit here and claim that I'm a Power Rangers fan. I was too old for that when it came out. I was aware of it mainly because my little sister was a huge fan, and I'm aware of it professionally now mainly through Linkara's show, and because I'm a fan of the Japanese tokusatsu genre in general, and I'm not gonna pretend that I suddenly take a less jaded view of the long-term viability of 90s popular culture. But I'm also not gonna pretend that there's even a dime's worth of difference when you get right down to it between Gen X film geeks getting unironically psyched for The Avengers, or X-Men, or G.I. Joe, or whatever else, and Gen Y kids and millennials doing the same damn thing over this, because that would be silly of me. Sure, there's conceivably a discussion to be had about degrees in this area of adaptation, i.e. stuff like Superman being legit 20th century folklore, or the various creations born of the maelstrom of creative energy during the Lee Kirby era at Marvel, versus what might have been the most nakedly commercial endeavor of the 90s, launched by one of the most nakedly commercial producers who ever lived, a series conceived only to sell toys, repurposed from a Japanese series also conceived only to sell toys, that hasn't wavered in that money-making formula for 22 f***ing seasons and counting of continuity, but still, it's only degrees. It's going to be interesting to see this play out, though. The first generation of movie nerd fan bloggers who grew up and became the new establishment as the industry transformed into an assembly line for movies that they always wanted to see, and that they were best qualified to opine on, are now looking at an entirely new generation coming up behind them, with their own nostalgia hang-ups and that should be a movie dreams. Wouldn't it be great if we could do what every other newly minted crop of old people failed to do and just acknowledge that just because it's outside our particular wheelhouse doesn't mean whatever unfamiliar goofery the kids are bringing to the table is undeserving of the same shot we asked the old guard to give our unfamiliar goofery back in the day. Because seriously, if you're looking down your nose at a 20-year-old who's nervous or psyched or having any kind of serious response whatsoever to a Power Rangers movie, or that Rescue Rangers movie Disney greenlit a few months back, or whatever other 90s property is next on the list, and you're in your 30s and still all pumped up about Batman, I don't have to tell you what that makes you look like, do I? I'm Bob, and that's The Big Picture.